Hello, my name is Rainer Hanekamp. This is Engineers with the latest updates from the Angular community every week. An interesting PR popped up, which introduces a new feature which is called the resource snapshot. Whenever we want to create a derived resource from another resource, we could technically do this via recomputed. However, that approach would require re-implementing all members of the resource type. It would also become fragile in the future, because if the resource is going to be extended, we would have to update our implementation as well. An alternative way could be to perform the mapping directly inside the original resource, for example within its loader, streaming, or parse functions. But that would also be a misuse of its original intention, and we would also lose the original value. If we look more closely to a read-only resource, we can say its core is in a way three different properties. It's the value, it's the status, and the error. And these three, they form together the resource snapshot. Therefore, when we want to produce a derived value, all we need is the snapshot, and our mapping function can both take and return a snapshot. Reconstructing the full read-only resource from that is straightforward, since the framework already provides the necessary helper functions. From a typing perspective, resource snapshot is also preferable. It's a union type which enables more precise type narrowing across the different states. Resource snapshot has already been merged. We will see if it makes it into Angular 21, but again, please be aware, resource is still experimental. And for the upcoming signal forms, which will also start in experimental mode, the official documentation has now landed. You are invited to give it a first look and share your feedback with the Angular team. Johannes Hoppe from Angular Schule published an article where he discusses three design decisions about the Rx resource that could be seen unintuitive or could be done better. First, when Rx resource fetches new data, it doesn't keep the previous value until the response for the new request arrives. When we reload a resource, a potential error also doesn't go away until the new response is in. And there is an issue when using Rx resource with the HTTP client, where the HTTP error is wrapped into another error. Johannes titled his article Rx resource is broken, which could be a little bit misleading, because in the end, this is about design decisions the Angular team took on purpose, and we know that the resource will evolve over time. In fact, the issue with loading and keeping the previous value will already be fixed with the resource snapshot. Ricky Lopes discussed how error handling is done within Zoneless applications. In Zone.js, whenever an error happened in asynchronous tasks, Zone.js catched that one and passed it on to the error handler. Without Zone.js, we need to call provide browser global error listeners to get that old behavior back. If you create a new Angular application today, this is already included by default. And that's it. I wish you a nice week. See you in the next episode. Goodbye.